Hello dear students, today we discussing chapter 12 topic ratio and proportion. This is the continuation of part 1. In this part we discuss about proportion. Here we discuss about what is the proportion, explanation with example, numbers in proportional general form, example of proportion, unitary method, example of unitary method, what we learn in the whole chapter, and some assignments for student. Now, what is proportion? Students, proportion means equal or even values. Now, we will understand it with the help of example. In nature drawing, drawn in a rectangular sheet of length 5 inch and breadth 7 inch. If we want to expand the picture, we can increase its length or breadth. But if we increase only its length 2 times or only its breadth 2 times, then the picture is not like the original picture. This we can see in the imager. So, how can we get the expanded picture? If we expand length and breadth both 2 times or multiple times, then we get expanded picture of original one. So, to get expanded picture looking like original, we have to increase its length and breadth both in equal ratio. Or, ratio of length of original picture to its breadth is equal to the ratio of length of expanded picture to its breadth. Then we get the expanded picture like the original one. Now, the ratio of length of picture is given 5 inches and breadth is 7 inches. So, the ratio of length and breadth of given picture equals to 5:7. 5:7 equals to 5/7. If we multiply numerator and denominator by 2, we get 5 × 2 / 7 × 2 equals to 10/14 equals 10:14. If we multiply length and breadth with same number, then we get the expanded picture look like original one. So 5:7 is equals to 10:14. If two ratios are equal, then we say that they are in proportion. The symbol equal or four dots is used to show the proportion or equal ratio. So we can say that 5, 7, 10, 14 are in same proportion. 5:7 equals to 10:14. We cannot write 5:7 equals to 14:10 because 14:7 is not equals to 5/7. It equals 7/5. So, in proportion, sequence of numbers are very important. Proportion in general form. If A, B, C and D, four numbers are in proportion, then we can write A:B equals to C:D or A:B proportion to C:D or A/B equals to C/D. Here A, B, C and D are called terms. Note that we cannot change the sequence of A, B, C, D. We cannot write A, C, D, B. Here the sequence is important. In which A and D are called extreme terms and or end terms. and B and C are called middle terms. If four numbers A, B, C and D are in proportion, so the product of extreme terms is equals to product of middle terms. That means A into B is equals to B into C. Now, to understand proportion very clear, let us solve another example. Example, Lena and Sheena made 7 garlands. Out of 7 garlands, Sheena made 4 garlands and Lena made 3 garlands. By selling these garlands, they got rupees 35. How much money she got Sheena and Lena? Here, 4 garlands made by Sheena and 3 garlands made by Lena. Therefore, out of 7 garlands, Sheena works 4/7 part and Lena works 3/7 part. Therefore, ratio of work of Sheena to Lena is 4:3. In this proportion, amount got by Sheena 4/7 into 35, because 35 is the total amount, equals to 140/7, which gives rupees 20. Now, amount got by Lena 3/7 into 35, because 3/7 is the work part of Lena, which gives 105/7 equals to rupees 15. Ratio of amount of Sheena to Lena is equals to 20:15 equals to 4:3. Therefore, 4:3 equals to 20:15, or 4:3 proportion to 20:15. So, numbers 4, 3, 20 and 15 are in proportion. Now, some more example. First, are the ratios 1500 gram to 3 kg and 300 centimeter to 6 meter in proportion? Let us see. Ratio 1500 gram ratio 3 kg means 1500 gram ratio 3000 gram, because 1 gram is equals to 1 kilogram is equals to 1000 gram. So 3 kilogram is equals to 3000 gram, which is equals to 1500 divided by 3000 gives 1:2, because we divide numerator and denominator by 1500. In other ratio, 300 centimeter ratio 6 meter equals to 300 centimeter is equals to a ratio 600 centimeter, because 6 meter is equals to 600 centimeter. So 300:600 equals to 1:2. In both ratio, least values are same. Therefore, both ratios are equal. Therefore, 1500 gram ratio 3 kg is equals to 300 centimeter ratio 6 meter. 1500 gram, 3 kg, 300 centimeter and 6 meter are in proportion. Second example, are the ratio 15 centimeter to 2 meter and 10 second to 3 minute are in proportion? First, we see the ratio 15 centimeter to 2 meter equals to 15 centimeter is ratio 200 centimeter, because 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter, which is equals to 15:200. If we divide 15 and 200 by 5, then we get the least value 3:40. In other ratio, 10 second ratio 3 minute is equals to 10 second ratio 180 second. That means, because 1 minute is equals to 60 second, therefore 3 minute is equals to 180 second. So 10 second ratio 180 second means 10:180. If we divide 10 and 180 by 10, we get the least value 1:18. Here 3:40 is not equal to 1:18. Therefore, ratios are not equal. So 15 centimeter, 2 meter, 10 second and 3 minute are not in the proportion. Now, unitary method. What is the unitary method? Unit means finding for one. Students, in daily life, we see many examples that if we know one value of an object, then we can find the values of required object. For example, if we know the price of one dozen banana, then we can find the price of half dozen or two dozen banana. If price of one dozen banana is equals to rupees 40, therefore the price of half dozen banana rupees 20 and the price of two dozen banana is equals to rupees 80. In this way, we can find the value which we want. So, the method in which first we find the value of one unit and then the value of required number of units is known as unitary method. To understand unitary method, we take some more example. Suppose Rohan fenced his house with wire. He made 3 round wire fence of expenditure rupees 9072. Then find the expenditure of 5 round wire. Solution is, given that expenditure for making fence of 3 round is equals to rupees 9072. Therefore, expenditure for fence of 1 round wire is equals to 9072 divided by 3 is equals to rupees 3024. Therefore, expenditure for fence of 5 round of wire is equals to 5 into 3024 is equals to rupees 15120. So student, when we go to a shop to purchase pen or pencil, shopkeeper told that the price of one pen or pencil. With the help of this, we can purchase what we want. Likewise, a vegetable seller told us the price of 1 kg of any vegetable. From this, we can find the price of 250 gram, half kg, 1.5 kg or 2 kg gram of vegetable. To find the required distance covered in given quantity of petrol, a scooter driver see that his scooter goes how many distance in 1 liter petrol. In this way, we can say that to find the value of required units, first we find the value of one unit. This method is called unitary method. Example, a car goes 50 km in 2 hours, how many distance covered by car in 6 minutes? To solve this question, first we see that all values are in the same ratio. Given distance covered by car in 2 hours is equals to 50 km. We know that 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. Therefore, 2 hours is equals to 120 minutes. So, distance covered by car in 120 minutes is equals to 50 km. Therefore, distance covered by car in 1 minute is equals to 50 divided by 120, which is equals to 50 by 120 gives 5 by 12 kilometer. Therefore, distance covered by car in 6 minutes is equals to 5 by 12 into 6 is equals to 2.5 kilometer. What we have learned in the whole topic, that means ratio and proportion. Comparison of two quantities by division is called ratio. If least value of two ratio are equal, then they are called equivalent ratio. The ratio may occur in different situation. The ratio 3 ratio 2 is different from 2 ratio 3. Thus, the order in which quantities are taken to express their ratio is important. A ratio may be treated as fraction. Example, 10 ratio 3 may treated as 10 by 3. To find the ratio of two quantities, their units should be same. Four quantities are in proportion if the ratio of first and second quantity are equal to the ratio of third and fourth quantities. The order of terms in proportion is important. The method in which we first find the value of one unit and then find the value of required number of units is known as unitary method. Students, here some assignment for you. First, you solve all the examples and exercise of NCERT textbook. Here, some multiple choice questions are given. Read carefully and try to solve it. Now, some practice questions are given. Read carefully and solve the questions. Students, here some interesting PISA-based questions. Read carefully this question and try to solve the questions. From given information, give the answers of the following. Thank you.